A magician named Angier is doing a magic show. From the stage, he asks for some volunteers to inspect his magic device. Among the volunteers, another magician named Borden decides to try to uncover its secret. Borden is still unsatisfied and sneaks backstage just before Angier's performance begins. Angier then starts the show and enters the electric sparks from the machine. While the flash blinds the audience, a hidden door opens, throwing him into a water tank under the stage. The audience is left in awe as Angier disappears. Little do they know, Angier is stuck inside a locked water tank. Borden witnesses Angier desperately grasping for air and tries to free Angier from the tank, but it is too late as Angier has died. Days after, Borden is accused of the death of Angier because he was at the scene when the incident occurred. In the court, Angier's stage engineer, Cutter, testifies how Borden was the only suspect on the scene. However, the jury asks Cutter to unravel the secret of Angier's magic illusion called the Real Transported Man to back his testimony, but Cutter refuses. Cutter doesn't want to reveal his and Angier's secret publicly. To solve this, the judge then asks Cutter to explain it to him in private, to which Cutter agrees. After the trial, Borden is put in jail to wait for his punishment. One day, a man named Owen comes to visit Borden. He presents himself as a solicitor for a noble named Lord Caldlow, who is interested in buying Borden's tricks. Borden agrees to sell the tricks and tells Owen to give the money to his stage engineer. However, Owen also demands a trick called the Transported Man. But Borden refuses to sell his greatest trick. Owen tells him that the court will revoke the custody of Borden's daughter to persuade Borden. But Lord Caldlow offers to adopt her if Borden agrees to sell that trick. Owen then passes a journal that once belonged to Angier before he left Borden to consider his offer. At night, Borden read Angier's journal, which recounts an event 2 years ago when he tried to meet a scientist named Nikola Tesla. Angier explains that he has to meet Tesla for a project he aims to build. However, luck isn't on Angier's side that day as he couldn't meet with Tesla on his first visit. Back at the hotel, Angier reads Borden's journal and reminisces how he and Borden once worked as stage assistants for another magician named Milton. In a flashback, Angier and Borden pretend to be volunteers on Milton's show to tie Julia, who will perform an escape trick. While tying Julia, Angier sneakily kisses Julia's thigh, to which she responds with a smile. After being tied, Julia is pulled by a hook and put into the water tank, followed by a curtain drop. A few seconds later, the curtain is raised, with Julia successfully escaping from the water tank. After the show, Borden mocks Milton's trick and claims he knows how to perform better. Cutter then challenges Borden and Angier to unravel the secret of a Chinese magician's trick and promises to give them a chance to perform if they succeed. Before the two men leave, Cutter scolds Borden for using a knot that could put Julia in danger and scolds Angier for kissing Julia's leg on the stage, which could reveal their relationship to the audience. Afterward, Borden and Angier watch the Chinese magician's performance. After the show, Borden admires the magician, while Angier doubts it. Angier suspects that the magician could be hiding the props under his baggy garments and hunched posture. He then tries to do it and finds it challenging but not impossible. At night, Angier and his wife Julia dream he should use the Great Danton for his stage name one day. Meanwhile, Borden meets with a girl named Sarah and her nephew when he works at a small magician show. When the magician makes a bird disappear from the stage, Sarah's nephew cries because he thinks the magician has killed and replaced the bird. After the show, Borden tries to cheer the boy up while getting to know Sarah. Borden then asks them out for lunch. After lunch, Borden escorts Sarah back to her apartment, but Sarah tells him she can't invite Borden over. Borden accepts that and leaves just when Sarah is about to enter her apartment. To her surprise, Borden magically reappears inside her room for some magical time. Back to the present day, Cutter shows the device that Angier used on his last day. He tells the judge that the water tank Borden allegedly used to kill Angier has a history related to both men. In another flashback, Borden and Angier are again tying Julia before a performance. However, Julia and Borden quietly agree to use the other knot, disobeying Cutter's instruction. When the rope pulls and drops Julia into the water tank, Cutter watches nearby in case of emergency. After a while, Julia hasn't escaped yet. Cutter then rushes to remove the curtain and reveals that Julia is stuck inside the water tank. They try to break the glass but it is too late. Julia's death takes a heavy toll on Angier. Borden shows up on the day of Julia's funeral to offer his condolences. Angier blames Borden for the death of his wife and asks Borden what knot he used on Julia that day. However, Borden says he doesn't remember and immediately leaves the place, angering Angier even more. Weeks later, Borden introduces a man named Fallon to Sarah, who will be working as his stage engineer. Sarah tells Borden they can't afford Fallon, but Borden assures her they will manage. Sarah then informs Borden that she is now pregnant with their child, so she forbids Borden from doing dangerous tricks. But Borden is sure that his trick isn't dangerous. Later on the stage, Borden opens his performance with a boring trick, causing the audience to mock him. Borden then pulls a pistol out to raise the enthusiasm and asks for a volunteer to shoot him while he catches the bullet. A man volunteers to shoot the gun at Borden. When Borden sees the man closely, it turns out to be Angier in disguise. Driven by grief and anger, Angier asks Borden the same question as before. But Borden still gives the same answer, causing the tension to rise. Suddenly, Fallon tries to snatch the gun from Angier, making Angier shoot Borden's finger instead. Borden screams in pain as Angier leaves the scene. Days after that, Sarah is concerned by Borden's wound and the loss of two of his fingers. Borden tells Sarah that he can still pull out the greatest trick to make him famous. Months later, Angier reunites with Cutter, who lost his job ever since Julia's incident. He agrees to help start Angier's career as a famous magician, the Great Danton. In addition, Cutter also hires a pretty woman named Olivia as Angier's assistant. After some preparation, they demonstrate their trick to a theater owner and successfully impress him. On the day of the show, Angier asks for two volunteers from the audience. Then, Angier tells the volunteers to place their hands on the cage in his hand. But when Angier sees one of the volunteers' faces, he is shocked to see Borden in disguise. Borden then sabotages Angier's device, which kills the bird inside the cage and cuts the finger of the woman's volunteer. Because of this, the theater owner cancels Angier's show. With their show cancelled, Cutter tells Angier to visit a science exhibit in town for some inspiration. The following day, Angier visits the science exhibit. He witnesses one of Tesla's stunning inventions. Angier also notices Borden sitting undisturbed by the dangerous-looking device amidst the panicking audience. Angier sneakily follows Borden. While tailing Borden, Angier sees Borden meeting up with his wife Sarah and his daughter named Jess. The scene makes Angier jealous, witnessing a family he could have had with Julia if Borden didn't make a fatal mistake. Back in the present time, Fallon and Jess visit Borden in jail. Borden learns from Fallon that the court plans to take Jess's custody from him. Having no choice, Borden asks Fallon to inform Owen that he is willing to accept his offer. In another flashback, Angier read about Borden's success in the newspaper. Olivia tells Angier that now they are even, he should let go of his obsession for vengeance. But Olivia's words don't affect Angier at all. Later in the evening, Angier goes to see Borden's performance. He is astonished by the trick called the Transported Man, where Borden throws a ball, enters a door, and then reappears from the other door to catch it. When Angier tells Cutter about it, Cutter explains that it might involve a body double. Believing that they could perform the same trick and present it better, they plan to find a body double for him. Days later, Olivia introduces an exactor named Root to Angier and Cutter. At first, Angier doubts if the man can impersonate him. But Cutter assures Angier that he can transform Root within a month. After that, they prepare for a show called The New Transported Man. When Angier and Olivia are rehearsing, they have a romantic moment together. However, Cutter interrupts it and asks them to see Root's rehearsal. To their surprise, Root successfully impersonates Angier's looks and acts on stage. On the show day, Angier tosses his hat in the air, then enters one door on the stage and instantly reappears on the opposite door to catch the hat. While Angier hides under the stage, Root receives the crowd's applause on the stage. After the show, Angier expresses his discomfort with his part. He asks Cutter if he and Root can switch places for the next performance, but Cutter doubts if Root can copy Angier's showmanship in building the audience's hype. After they are left alone, Olivia kisses Angier to celebrate their success. But, Angier is still unsatisfied and can't get over how Borden did it better. Suddenly, Angier comes up with an idea and asks Olivia to work for Borden at his workshop. That way, Olivia will be Angier's spy to learn Borden's secret. Olivia is against the idea but agrees to it anyway. The following day, Olivia goes to Borden's workshop to meet the man. Olivia explains that she wants to change sides as she can't work with Angier anymore. To earn Borden's trust, Olivia offers to tell Borden about Angier's secret. However, Borden already knows how Angier did his transported man trick and mocks him in front of Olivia. Days later, Cutter is shocked when Root demands a pay rise. With no other choice, Angier tells Cutter to accept Root's demands for now until they uncover the secret of Borden's trick. Later that night, Root purposely performs poorly by delaying his appearance, which ruins the show. Unbeknownst to Angier, Borden had manipulated Root into realizing that he had control over Angier's show to make demands. When Angier is about to perform his usual trick another night, the cushion underneath the trapdoor disappears when he falls. As Angier screams in pain, he realizes it is not Root waiting at the other platform but Borden instead. Suddenly, Borden comes out from the opposite door of Angier's stage, surprising the audience. Soon after, Root appears tied and gagged on top of the stage, ruining Angier's reputation, while Borden successfully steals his stage. After that incident, Angier confronts Olivia and blames her. Angier suspects that Olivia sabotages his show by telling Borden too much information. But, Olivia convinces Angier of her loyalty by giving him Borden's journal. Olivia reminds Angier that his obsession is too far, and it will not bring his wife back, but Angier still won't listen to her. At the end of their meeting, Angier tells Olivia that he will pretend to break into Borden's workshop as if he stole the journal to keep Olivia out of Borden's suspicion. One evening, Angier stalks Borden after his show. Fallon notices it and tails Angier with a pistol in his hand. Suddenly, Angier changes his path and walks into an alley. Fallon decides to keep following Angier and falls into a trap set by Angier and Cutter. However, Fallon manages to injure Cutter in the process. A moment later, Borden meets with Angier in a graveyard. With Fallon as a hostage, Angier demands Borden to write down the method of his trick. Borden then writes something on the note and passes it to Angier. Angier then leaves and tells Borden to dig the grave if he wants to save Fallon. When Angier meets with Cutter at the hospital, they both read that Borden had written Nikola Tesla's name on the note as a clue to his trick. Before Angier goes to meet Tesla in America, Cutter tells him that he can no longer participate in Angier's obsession. At first, Tesla's assistant refused to let Angier meet with Tesla. But some days later, Tesla sends his assistant to meet him to discuss his intention. The assistant shows a glimpse of Tesla's experiment and then invites him to meet Tesla. The following day, Angier is fascinated when Tesla casually walks over electricity sparks unscathed. Over lunch, Tesla tells Angier that his request comes with a cost, but Angier assures him that cost is not a problem. Days later, Tesla presents his invention to Angier. But the result causes concern for both Tesla and Angier. When Angier reads the last page of Borden's journal, Borden mocks him for believing his false clue. It is revealed that Olivia betrayed Angier and purposely handed the journal to misdirect him. After that, Angier thought that Tesla had been scamming him all along. When he is ranting about it to Tesla's assistant, Tesla comes to assure Angier that he is not scamming him. They use a cat for the test subject this time, but the result is still the same. When Angier leaves Tesla's laboratory in disappointment, the sound of a commotion nearby pulls his interest. To his surprise, Angier sees two similar cats appear on the ground along with dozens of his hats. They have been working on a duplication device all this time, but it is not working perfectly. With hope, Tesla asks Angier to give him time to fix the machine. Meanwhile, the relationship between Borden and Sarah is getting worse. Borden assures Sarah that he only loves her and their daughter. But Sarah remains doubtful. Borden meets with Fallon and asks for his help convincing Sarah and taking Jess to the zoo. Afterward, Borden goes to Olivia, but he doesn't kiss her back when she greets him. Olivia reminds him to only think of her whenever he is with her and leaves his family at home. In Colorado, Angier finds that Edison's men have burned down Tesla's laboratory. He thinks that his device has been lost in the fire and decides to return empty-handed. When he is about to check out, the hotel manager tells him that Tesla has left a package for him. In a letter, Tesla tells Angier that the device is working but comes with consequences. Angier doesn't heed Tesla's warning and decides to test it immediately. Back in the present day, Borden reads Angier's mock of how he is now reading his journal inside the jail on the last page of Angier's journal, waiting for his punishment. Later that day, Owen comes to visit Borden to collect the document of Borden's trick. However, Borden tells Owen he will give the other half of the documents if Lord Caldlow comes with Borden's daughter. In a flashback months before Angier's death, Borden and Sarah's relationship hit the lowest point because of Borden's alleged affair with Olivia. Amidst their arguments, Sarah asks Borden if he loves her or not, and Borden answers that he doesn't love her. The following day, Sarah is devastated by her husband's answer and decides to end her suffering. After Angier returns, he invites Cutter to an abandoned theater and asks Cutter's help to set out one last performance. Cutter agrees to help and then invites a showrunner for a demonstration. Angier goes into the device and is soon enveloped by lightning sparks and disappears, then reappears behind the showrunner, making him agree to fund Angier's performance. One afternoon, Olivia meets with Borden and asks him about Sarah's death. Borden tells her that he doesn't love Sarah even though he married and had a daughter with her. Borden insists that he loves Olivia instead, but Olivia doesn't believe what Borden just said. Before Olivia leaves, she informs Borden that Angier has returned with a new show. Later that night, Borden comes to Angier's performance and witnesses how Tesla's machine helps him disappear and reappear. Borden then meets Fallon in panic and asks him to try to unravel the secret. Fallon then goes to spy on Angier's backstage assistants but still can't figure out the mystery of it. Borden then decides that he doesn't want to know about it anymore and suggests they leave Angier alone. However, on the night of Angier's death, Borden still shows up to Angier's performance which ends with him being accused of Angier's death. A while later, Lord Caldlow and Jess visit Borden in jail. When Borden sees Lord Caldlow, he is shocked to know that it was Angier's true identity all along. Confused to see Angier still alive, Borden asks him to leave Jess out of their rivalry and bargain with a complete document of his greatest trick. However, Angier tears the document and leaves with Borden's daughter, leaving Borden to his demise. Back at Angier's manor, Cutter is just as shocked to see that Angier is still alive. A few moments before being hanged, Borden apologizes to Fallon for everything that happened. Afterward, Borden is taken to execution for the crime he didn't commit, while Angier hides Tesla's machine for good. Borden then says abracadabra as his last word, and at the same time, Fallon shows up and suddenly shoots Angier. It is then revealed that Fallon and Borden are twins who swap their identities for their performance. Fallon explains to Angier that one loves Sarah while the other loves Olivia. They've sacrificed their whole life to live the life of a man named Borden. Angier also reveals how he had created and killed his replica twins every night of his performance with Tesla's machine, showing that he also sacrificed a lot. In the end, Fallon leaves Angier to death along with the device and all of his replica corpses. Fallon then returns to Jess and takes her to safety as he nods to Cutter, who helped him end Angier. What would you do if you were a part of this story? Write your comment down below. Subscribe to watch more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like and comment to help the channel. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.